Beijing accusing Filipino troops of destroying Chinese fishing nets installed within the vicinity of Ayungin Shoal. China's state publication Xinhua made the allegation earlier this week, claiming troops on board the BRP Sierra Madre repeatedly damaged the fishing nets last May 15. It claims over 2,000 meters of Beijing's fishing nets were damaged, while more than 100 meters were confiscated. This allegation is the latest in a series of China's accusations against personnel of the BRP Sierra Madre. Beijing has also accused Filipino troops of pointing their guns at the China Coast Guard personnel last month. The Philippines has denied such allegation. Ayungin Shoal is well within Manila's exclusive economic zone, meaning the Philippines has sovereign rights over the area. Coast Guards from the U.S. and Japan committing to boost their presence in the West Philippine Sea. Manila earlier sought help from its allies amid China's growing maritime aggression. The Philippine Navy has monitored at least 125 Chinese vessels in the past week, particularly in the vicinity of Escuadra Shoal, where signs of island-building activities have been reported. This also comes ahead of the June 15 implementation of China's new detention policy.
They have no right to be within our EEZ. The conduct of an exercise is unauthorized under UNCLOS. It's not allowed. I would like to say their actions are all illegal, not within the bounds of international law.
For Senate President Francis Escudero, China's aggression should be tackled during the ongoing ASEAN Coast Guard Forum in Davao City.
Yan ang regional organization na kinabibilangan ng Pilipinas at hindi maikakaila. Ang isyong ito kaugnay sa West Philippine Sea ay nagaganap sa loob ng nasasakupan ng ASEAN.
Lahat po ng mga Coast Guard agencies na kasapi dito ay sumusunod po sa batas. So siguro po hindi po siya magiging isang pangunahing usapin dahil wala naman pong gumagawa ng ganun sa mga member natin sa ngayon.
A Philippine senator urges President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to declare POGOs a national security threat. As Victoria Tulet tells us, Senator Rizo Ontiveros is also more convinced controversial Banban Town Mayor Alice Go is involved in illegal POGOs.
After their executive session with various government agencies, Senator Rizo Ontiveros is now more convinced that there is basis to file criminal and administrative cases against Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go for her alleged connection with illegal Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs in her town. Among the agencies invited to the closed-door session are the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission and the Anti-Money Laundering Council.
Walang nakabawas o nakabura dun sa namumuo talagang opinion ng komite na siguradong may kinalaman siya sa Pogo Hub dyan sa Bamban. Dun pa lang sa documentary evidence, tapos syempre yung ilang mga inputs mula sa mga resource person.
Ontiveros also raised alarm over Go's business partners when she was still part of the Baofu Land Development Incorporated in Bamban, following reports that two of the incorporators have been implicated in the biggest money laundering case in Singapore.
Ang laki din ang sinasabing halaga ng kabuang Zunyuan complex na yan. Paano nakapasok at nakaikot sa ating ekonomiya kung walang malinaw na sources sina Mayor Alice Go at kanyang mga kasosyo.
The senator also maintained that there is no strong evidence proving Go is Filipino. The mayor was not invited to the meeting, but her lawyer submitted a letter to Ontiveros' office answering the allegations against her. According to Go, Baofu was a legitimate business when it started. She did not know that her business partners were involved in criminal activities, and she did not intend to represent Hongsheng in securing its letter of no objection from the local government of Bamban. After being elected mayor, she gave a permit to Zunyuan because its documents were complete. Go insisted that her father has nothing to do with money laundering. As for her personal life, Go said her true mother is Filipino citizen Amelia Leal and not the Chinese national Wen Yilin, who is her father's live-in partner and business partner. She also admitted her siblings are of different nationalities. The letter ended with Go swearing that she is not a protector of POGOs and has no hand in murder, prostitution, human trafficking, and other crimes.
During the executive session, Senator Riz Ontiveros appealed to the National Security Council to brief President Bongbong Marcos about the alleged national security threat that POGOs pose. Ontiveros could not give details because of the confidentiality of the matter, but said that the situation regarding POGOs is definitely alarming.
Paalisin na sila sa ating bayan. Kahit yung nagsisimulang legit or legal na POGO or POGO na may lisensya nung una, nagmo-morph din eh, nagmo-mutate na nagiging illegal.
The Senate will have another briefing with the Anti-Money Laundering Council before it holds the next public hearing on Mayor Go. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Over in Pampanga, Philippine authorities raid an illegal offshore gaming hub, which is believed to be bigger than the compound in Bamban. 29 Filipinos and more than 150 foreigners were rescued, most of them Chinese. At the Lucky South 99 in Angeles City, authorities conducted the operation following reports of human trafficking and abuse. Investigators are trying to determine who among those rescued are victims and perpetrators of the illegal operation.
Lalaki na hindi daw di umano nakakamit ng quota sa loob ng kumpanyang ito na Lucky South 99 at pinagpapapalo ng mga baseball bat. Nakakalungkot, meron kami natanggap ng mga balita na yung isa doong foreign national na subject noong video ay namatay na, cremated na nga po siya. Meron din po kami natanggap ng mga videos ng babae, foreign national, di umano, na pinagsasayaw online.
Lucky South 99 is the largest POGO hub in Pampanga Province with 46 buildings and a golf course. Based on records, the company committed violations in 2022 for the kidnapping of 43 Chinese nationals. But it was able to resume operations. A Philippine immigration authorities arrest 37 Chinese nationals allegedly involved in the illegal retail. The Immigration Bureau says the Chinese nationals were arrested inside the multinational village in Parañaque City after the BI received credible intelligence reports. They were found to be illegally involved in food retail, groceries, and restaurants. The arrest comes after Senator Rafi Tufo sounded the alarm over the influx of Chinese nationals in the village. Tulfo filed a Senate resolution Wednesday seeking a probe on the increasing presence of Chinese nationals in the Parañaque community. Some residents suspect illegal offshore gaming hubs are operating inside their subdivision. Senator Riz Ontiveros wants to reopen a Senate probe on the Health Department's transfer of pandemic funds to a budget department agency. Ontiveros says they are looking for new witnesses or new evidence of alleged anomalies in the 47.6 billion peso transfer. The Senate Blue Ribbon Committee first investigated the controversy in 2021, but the panel's first draft report was never elevated to the plenary.
Naghihintay lang talaga kami ng tinatawag na new matter, bagong resource person or whistleblower, bagong ebidensya. Gaano mang katagal, nananalig ako, malalaman pa rin natin ang katotohanan at masisingil pa rin ang accountability ng lahat ng gumawa ng pera dyan.
Families of drug war victims backing the International Criminal Court's probe on the Duterte administration's bloody campaign. They appeared before a House panel investigating the widespread killings during the previous administration. The families renew their calls to hold former President Rodrigo Duterte and others involved in the drug war accountable.
Narinig ko po na hindi po makikipag, na hindi po magko-cooperate ang committee sa na ito sa ICC investigation. Sige lang po. Pero nais ko pong sabihin na kami pong mga pamilya, doon kami nakasandig pa rin at nabubuhayan ng pag-asa sa ICC o International Investigation. May kumpiyansa kami na hindi nila...
House Human Rights Committee Chairperson Bienvenido Abante Jr. meanwhile vows to invite Duterte and the drug war architect Senator Ron De La Rosa to the hearing. But he asserts they will not be forced to attend.
So what I can promise is that we will be informing again Senator De La Rosa on the next hearing, and if you would like to attend, sabihin na natin doon, if you would like to come, you are welcome. We're going to inform the former president on this hearing. Okay? Now, pag na-inform siya, nasa kanya na yon, kung pupunta siya o hindi. But I would like to give full respect to the former president. Although he might not be tawag dito, exempt from this investigation, yet I think that we should give full respect to the former president, being a public official also.
Residents of a Negros Occidental town forced to flee from mudflows from the Canlaon volcano. The mudflow, triggered by heavy rains, swept through a village in La Castellana town 2 days after the volcano spewed a 5-kilometer-high ash cloud. La Castellana is now under a state of calamity. Canlaon is still at alert level 2. State volcanologists say it could still erupt within the next few days, despite its seemingly calm state. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Hi, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina. Good morning to all. We're currently not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, southwest monsoon continues to affect the western section of Luzon and Visayas. Due to this, expect a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Metro Manila, Ilocos Region, Cordillera Administrative Region, Zambales, Bataan, Tarlac, Pampanga, Bulacan, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, Western Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, Basilan, Sulu, and Tawi-Tawi. For the rest of our country, especially in the eastern section of our country, expect a generally fair weather with the chances of localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest here in PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel.